time persists. With each stroke of the clock, our world inches closer. Closer to an undetermined fate. A fate largely written by our actions, our choices, and those of our antecedents. With each stroke of the clock, the world we know is changing. Hypotheses of yesterday are the realities of today. Realities of today become the horrors of tomorrow. With each stroke of the clock, windows of opportunity are closing. Visions of scarcity cloud the promise of abundance. Innovation is stifled by the mere need to survive. The year is 2010. The place is the United States of America. This year, the unemployment rate increased 233% from where it was a decade ago. This year, the national debt climbed to a record high of $13.5 trillion. This year, less than one in three college graduates will find work in their fields of study. This year, there are over 1.5 million new cases of cancer in the country. This year, childhood obesity rates are 300% higher than they were 30 years ago. This year, the prevalence of diabetes reached 23.7 million cases, a figure that could double in the next 25 years. This year, medical expenditures will exceed $1.5 trillion. This year, our country's average life expectancy rates dropped to 38th amidst the global landscape. The year is 2010. The place is the United States of America. This is our reality. Amidst these dark and brutal facts lies a faint and glowing ember of opportunity. An opportunity that begins with the belief that we can be the difference, that we can affect change. An opportunity that is fueled by the 10 most powerful two-letter words in the English language. If it is to be, it is up to me. An opportunity to rise from this adversity, embrace the challenges before us, and create a legacy of strength and prosperity. It was a starkly similar opportunity that a young man from a different time and a different place saw. A young man that humbly believed that he held the ability to be the difference. A young man that lived by those words, if it is to be, it is up to me. A young man that possessed abilities no more extraordinary than any of us, but held a vision of capturing opportunity and bringing it forth. That man was Mr. Liao Soon Sang. Father, innovator, humanitarian. That vision was to bring a mythical 4,000-year-old herbal marvel into the lives of anyone willing to hear his message. That opportunity was and is Gano Excel. The year is 2010. This is our reality. The obstacles before us are unknown, but the path is clear. Our starving people need a beacon, a financial and moral light, guiding us to the pastures of abundance and prolonged life that we once knew. We are engaged in a trillion-dollar reality called wellness. A reality that places proactive prevention ahead of reactive treatment. A reality that has pushed natural superstars like Ganoderma lucidum out of obscurity and into the spotlight. A reality that has catapulted the vision of Liao Soon Sang across the world and into our beloved land. A land that inspires the world. A land that can further perpetuate his vision to every pocket of existence on our humble planet. A reality that has brought business visionaries like Jovan Kabasag and humanitarian visionaries like Liao Soon Sang together in one united cause, promise. Voices around the world call our home the land of opportunity, rising out of our adversity is this opportunity. The year is 2010. This is our reality. What will we do with it? Fear, 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 fear.